Next, we have Hila from Ada Health.
I always knew that health is one of the most important things in life, but I think I only fully understood the meaning of that when my dad was hospitalized in October 2015 due to an array of alarming symptoms. Doctors were not able to find out what he had, and the search for the right diagnosis continued over months. I remember that this experience really made me wonder if it is so difficult to find the right diagnosis in Germany with one of the most elaborated health systems in the world, what would have happened if my dad would have been in his home country, Afghanistan, where even accessing primary healthcare services proved to be a major challenge. And as we all know, this challenge is real. There's currently over 4 billion people that lack access to basic primary healthcare services. At Ada, it is our vision that everyone on Earth has access to the healthcare they need and deserve by using the power of AI and mobile technology. So how do we do this? How does this work? Ada is a personal health companion that helps you to understand and manage your health. This means that she's an interactive chatbot that first asks you about your presenting complaint and then asks more and more until she has collected enough evidence to provide guidance on possible conditions, but also on what potential next steps to take. We have developed our medical reasoning engine over the past 7 years with the help of a lot of researchers, medical doctors, and engineers to solve the puzzle of diagnosis once and for all. With over 12,000 diseases out there and an infinite number of potential conditions as symptom constellations, it is simply impossible for the human brain to be able to identify all of these. We have an accuracy of over 90%, and Ada has helped already over 5 million users all around the world to help them to take better informed decisions. However, in low and middle income countries, many people, especially in rural areas, lack access to smartphones. And in order to ensure that even the hardest to reach populations have also access to high quality personalized health information, we seek to partner up now with community health worker organizations and local government to adapt our existing solutions to the needs and requirements of community health workers, drug shop dispensers, and pharmacists so we can ensure that they are equipped with the right tool with clinical decision support that is informing their next steps and especially more timely and appropriate referrals of patients. By putting Ada into the hands of frontline healthcare workers, this also results in real-time aggregated population insights that can anticipate public health needs and inform especially outbreak control and mitigate that. By becoming an MIT Solvers, you would really help us to advance this work. We're only at the beginning of this, and it would take partnerships and the collective intelligence of this room of experts to help us form the right partnerships so we can create long-lasting impact. Thank you very much. Thank
you. Cheryl?
Thank you, Hila. Fantastic presentation, as yesterday. Really, really interesting solution, and especially your new ambitions to reach low-income communities. And so can you talk about the impact, where you just left off in your presentation? What impact has the solution shown already in developed markets, and what are you hoping for in emerging markets?
So what we can definitely see in, we have, I mean, the 5 million users that we have already, we have received over 100,000 of reviews. And what's interesting is that half of those users are also in low-income countries. What we can see in high-income countries from some of these reviews is that they say, finally, somebody's listening to me. Because, you know, the doctor has time pressure, less than 5 or 6 minutes usually. And Ada is just asking more and more questions until she gets sort of to what it could be. And we also see that a lot of people that have rare diseases say that, okay, it took my doctor 5 years to find out what I have, and Ada found it out within a few minutes. So we see this type of impact, and we have a lot of validation also underway. Right now with clinical universities, with university research hospitals that look specifically also at the time savings that Ada can provide. But from what I always find very inspiring is really the personal stories that people really send to us. Ada has saved my life, or my doctor has told me I have an acute gastritis. They sent me at home. I did Ada. They said it's an acute appendicitis. I got immediate surgery that day. So that's the type of impact that we can see already. In low-income countries, we see that, for instance, a review by a son of a drug shop owner in Nigeria who said, hey, I have people coming in every day to my father's drug shop, and this is how we make our livelihoods, and they ask us for medical advice, but we're not equipped to give them any, and it feels wrong to turn them down. So he said, I started using Ada to be able to triage patients in some way or another, so we can also see that people not only use it for themselves, but actually for others.
Thank you very much. Fascinating use of technology for this. Have you thought about the secondary potentials of the data that you're holding? You said over 2 million of the inquiries coming from low and middle income countries. Is there potential for that to be linked back to government as surveillance capacity, just to flag, you know, particular issues that have been raised to your attention?
Yeah, absolutely. I recently had a very good conversation also with a WHO member about this, that we can make all of that interoperable and we can link it to national data systems. But this is also sort of, we have all these aggregated insights. And for instance, we put in our system Lassa fever and we saw retrospectively a spike in a system in West Africa. And there's a whole, and we're happy, you know, to provide this and make this another source for WHO or government specifically to anticipate these public health needs.
Thank you. Okay.